in the whole of this crisis that has we've had in the past month or thereabouts, you notice that the executive committee has been very silent and mature about the whole thing, because we believe that at the end of the day, nobody has fought football and won. So we knew where it would end, and we all believe that football must be the winner, not Amaju Pinnick or Shehia Kiyomi or whoever it is. It should be football, and therefore, if we call football a family, then we must be able to resolve it as we preach. We've been preaching that we shouldn't go to court. We should preach that we should have a family unit, and that's what we have done. So we always knew we were going to come this way, but we need people to know who the authentic elected board is. And you know, it's established that we were the elected board, as we have seen from the Congress today. But you don't take everything and cut people's neck. Give them the opportunity, leave the door open for people to come in and join the family again. People err from time to time, but if you allow them to come in and correct their mistakes, we'll all live happily ever after. The important thing is, you know, we've left the door open for them. This is Congress, and we brought it to Congress. So it's up to them now to take the door, to come in through the door that we've left open for them. People have been complaining that it's exclusive, we don't allow people to come in to vote and take part in elections. The door is open now. Everybody is allowed, who's willing and able to come in, to come and take part in these elections. So it's not really, the onus is not on us. We've shifted the onus to them. We've extended the olive branch. So it's now for them to do what is needful. And I've done this not from a point of weakness. So nobody can say, oh, we're desperate, that's why we had to call them in. We've done this after we've called the Congress, all for